A prosperous society, a society whose political and other institutions are functioning well and serving us, is only sustainable in a cultural context in which the American people are working well together based on the strength of our interpersonal and our intergroup relationships. When that deteriorates, when that breaks down, the only thing that may hold us together to a degree for a while is material prosperity. But what happens behind the scenes of that is that we're all seeking to sabotage each other politically and to punish each other socially. And so when that disappears, our ability to collaborate on meaningful things necessary to the survival and prosperity of our country disappears. That is what I said well before the advent of COVID-19. That is what I said well before our inability to marshal a collective societal response to, you know, a health threat, which has been obviously, it's far beyond just being a threat to public health. It has crashed the American economy in a way that hasn't happened since the Great Depression. And whether you think that we should have gone right or left in our policy response to that and how we implemented countermeasures, the fact is that any meaningful way of engaging a response there would have required the strong consensus of the American people politically in a way that would have necessitated some minimum threshold of civic trust to exist between us on a social and a cultural level. And that is obliterated when we put our faith in parties and politicians that are situated in such a way to where their pathway towards success and influence is predicated on division as opposed to fostering unity. And so the more we invest our political and our social capital and confidence in those sorts of politicians, in those sorts of political parties, and parties can change, right? But in those sorts of structures, the more we ensure that that is going to be the pathway to our demise, and the only meaningful thing that we're choosing between when we choose between different variations of those alternatives is perhaps what the timeline looks like or just how exactly that winds up expressing itself. And so, yeah, I mean, I've actually been making this argument well before Unity 2020, because even beyond Unity 2020, it is again a question of what sort of politics do we want to stand for on the base most cultural, foundation most cultural level, right? And we need to stand for a politics that strengthens our relationships as a people rather than destroys them.